and welcome. This is Anadufu Show. I'm Anwar Kalil, your host. My guest today is Dr. Getachew Dingu. He is an instructor at Addis Ababa University, the School of Journalism and Communication. And he's going to tell us a lot of things about himself and the profession. Stay tuned. Anadufu, Doctor.
Thank you so much for having me on your show, Anwar.
I mostly, of course, always begin by asking birthplace of my guesses. And let's begin from that.
Yeah. I was born in Iloababora zone, a small town called Algay. So I like that place very much. Not very many people know about Algay, where it is located. The only time the town's name gets mentioned is when they give a meteorology report, and there is some chance a meteorologist receives from the amount of rain, and every time it gets mentioned, I get very happy.
By the way, you are from the Sagalen Ilu. The Sagalen Ilu family, by the way, that's actually currently is Bunno Badele and Ilu Babor zones.
Yeah.
But the Sagalen Ilu, the nine Ilu ancestors,
yes,
or the Ilus.
Mm-hmm.
And you grew up there?
Not really. I stayed there only for 5 years. And then my father, who was a teacher, got transferred to Addis Ababa, first Harar, and then to Addis. Family stayed there for a while after he left, and then my mother, who was a business person, she decided to move the family to Addis. So when I came to Addis, I was only 5 years old.
5 years old, and you grew up here in Finfinne.
Yes.
And what I heard was true. It means in that case, I know I need your words. When Dr. Getachew, when he came to Finfinne, he only spoke of Oromo and not Amharic.
That's true.
And how did you win the challenges then?
Yeah, it was very challenging. You know, it felt very strange and culture shock. And then the kids I grew up with in Addis, they were not like me. And it was very intimidating in a way. And kids are kids, they are not political. But they give you names and everything. So I remember some of the names I had when I was a child, related to my ethnic background and the language I spoke. They made fun of my accent and the way I spoke Amharic. But as a kid, you quickly learn language, and it didn't take me long time to learn Amharic and speak it like they do.
You finally won the battle.
I won.
The same experience you have got with Baalu Grima, by the way. Baalu Grima, when he came to Finfinne, he
never spoke
Amharic, only till he's 14, I think. He only spoke Amharic up on Romo, and later he became a wonderful writer, even in Amharic.
Yes, where Baalu Grima was born is Supe, Boru.
Yeah.
It's not, I think, 15 or 14 kilometers far from where I was born.
Wow.
Very close. I went to see his home, you know, the house he was born in, the neighborhood he grew up in, and that was very exciting for me.
His mother passed away recently.
Really?
Yeah, somebody told me that. What about your school life? Let's talk about it.
I started elementary school in Addis, around Kolfe area. It's called Safara Salam. First school I went to is called Kastada Mana, and then Yakati 23 Elementary School, which is a public school. And I finished elementary and junior school in the former Wasansagat, later on changed its name to Yakati 23. And my high school was Kolfe Comprehensive Secondary School. I studied there from grade 9 to 11. So when I was grade 12, I decided to go back to Mattu.
Is it your decision or your father's decision?
It was actually my own decision. I thought taking ESLC examination in the regions might be better than taking it in Addis. And then because I had relatives, aunts, and my brother and all my family, some of my family members, it wasn't difficult for me to go back to Mattu and finish grade 12 there. And then I passed the ESLC examination. That year, only two students passed for a degree program. And one of them was myself. And then I was assigned at Asmara University, where I stayed.
Oh, the capital of Eritrea today.
Yes, yes.
The then one province of Ethiopia.
Exactly.
Okay.
And then it was only 1 year that I spent there. And then because of the situation, political situation and change of government, I had to be transferred to Addis Ababa University. So the rest 3 years I finished in Addis Ababa University. I majored in foreign languages and literature. My BA was in foreign languages and literature.
What about your master's degree and PhD?
My master's degree was in 2006, and that was in journalism and communication from Addis Ababa University. And then upon graduation, I was hired as a lecturer and assistant dean of School of Journalism and Communication. After serving for 3 years, I got the opportunity to study for my PhD in the United States. I went to University of Nebraska, Lincoln, and did my PhD, finished it 2014. And majoring in communication studies.
And you stayed in the States for about a decade? Is that so?
No, really, a little less than a decade, about 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, about 8 years, yes.
Is that for your PhD that you stayed there, or were you doing some jobs there?
The study took longer than I thought, about 6.5, 7 years. I wanted to take as many courses as possible. I couldn't have enough of the courses. I liked them, and then willingly I, the way it works there, you discuss it with your advisor, you plan your own program of study, and then once yourself and your advisor agree, you can take courses from different departments. I had to go to education department, take courses from very prominent professors like John Creswell. If you name five professors in the world who are really good, who have produced many books and widely read books in the field of research, quantitative, qualitative, mixed methods research, John Creswell would be one of them. I have taken two courses from him, and I have also taken courses from sociology, from other departments as well. So anything that I thought will help me for my career in the future.
That helped you to know at least something about everything.
Indeed, yes, it did help me. So it took me 6.5 years, the study, and then another 1 year I was hired by my own university, my own department, as a senior lecturer. And I taught American undergraduate students courses, introductory courses to communication, to public speaking, and some of. So it was very interesting.
And then you came back home.
I came back home. Yes.
And still you're teaching at Arizona University.
That's right.
And I also heard that Dr. Getachew loves teaching. Is it true?
That's my passion. Above anything else, I like teaching. And then as a kid, I always wanted to become a teacher.
Like your father?
Yes, partly because my dad was a teacher. And I was respected as a kid. And then part of my elementary school was where he was teaching. So when you are a son of a teacher, you get respect. You know, he belongs to Teacher Dinku. And then, so that gives you a feeling that this might be a very good profession. And then it actually is a very good profession. I came to realize I loved it. And it's not because I didn't get other chances. I worked for a prominent international NGO for like 6 years, about 6 years. That was a good paying profession as a communication officer and regional coordinator. And it gave me exposures, and also in terms of pay, you can't compare it to what you earn working as a teacher. But I still prefer to come back, do my master's, and also pursue teaching at the university. And also after coming back with my PhD, I was appointed by the government. In fact, it was the prime minister who appointed me to a big position. But I really wanted to go back to the university and teach.
And even recently, you let them down not to be, you know, dean of the School of Journalism and Communication ahead. Is that true?
Yeah, that's true. After Dr. Nagari left, he was appointed by the government, and I had to step in, fill his position, and serve there as a school head for 1 year. And then after a year, I decided to quit, and I resigned. It was good. I had, I think, a successful term. My colleagues and students wanted me to continue that capacity, but I said, look, the most important place for me in the university is the classroom. You know, as long as I have the classroom, as long as I have the students, that's fine. I don't like the bureaucratic part of it, the administrative part of it, and also the university. I don't know about other universities, but at Addis Ababa University, most of the tasks, most of the activities are at the school department level, but the system does not support. You know, the infrastructure and all the resources are in a very centralized way. They are managed in a very centralized way. I found that to be a little bit frustrating, and then, okay, let somebody else give it a try, but not me.
Yeah. Now, teachers with such a passion for teaching should create generations with that quality as well. That's the way I believe, by the way. I love teaching. I know I love teaching as well, like you said, because the best for everything is teaching.
That's right.
Wow. But in developing nations, it's not that way considered. But the truth is, it is base for every science.
That's true.
And Dr. Getacho loves sports.
Yes, especially football.
Soccer.
And
I heard that you are a fan of Arsenal.
That's true.
But recently you might have been annoyed.
I don't tell students which club I support, because I don't want to offend the Chelsea fans, the Man United fans, and also Man City fans.
But today the right time to talk about it. You know,
that's right. Okay.
Your Arsene Wenger, the French professor, is annoying. You know, his fans recently. Wenger out. What's your comment on that?
He doesn't want to go away. You know, but I think it's time for him to go. I think he's given everything. Due respect for his contributions over the last 20 plus years, and he's done a lot for the club, and you know, lots of success during his reign. But recently, he's not winning trophies, and the club. I think he's gone out of he's run out of ideas, and then maybe it's time for somebody else to come and try.
Have you ever visited Highbury or Fly Emirates Stadium in London?
True.
Recently,
I got a chance to go to London on a business. So I was with the Ethiopian delegation. And then I had to steal from my time in London and sneak out from the hotel we were staying in and go to North London to see the Emirates Stadium. Yeah, I visited their souvenir shop. I had to buy some souvenir from the shop. I love Thierry Henry.
Thierry Daniel Henry.
I brought a mug with me, and then it has
Thierry
Henry,
Daniel
number
Henry.
14 on it.
All right.
Yes.
Number 14, then later went to Walcott, Thierry Walcott.
That's right, yes.
Now he left Hart.
Yeah, he's at Everton right now.
And what other hobbies do you have?
Kanisin dawa chajertan obien ra harira ta ganamati harira ta ganama Kenya ga garat umrat fi neti kanjiru harira ta Kenya har aki sati ga fi ga fan neti kanjiru ga fi Kenya kunisi ga kubeti nu kan World Cup tu da har wai bar nu thati World Cup si sudan ode fan nu ti kena onle si kan ma World Cup si sudan mo wai kubet an World Cup si snele ga fi ga fan neti ga kan turre ga fi sunis kubet dubbi fama afan romu kesa kam tu hit lamed yo kini mo hit ilaman dubbata ma hit ilaman wal tu kuran dubbata ma kanjiru karir gababa saddeet tamisa di soddomi to korate nu ferga bad afama arira ta kenya gana mata asin injenne te ga kanjiru arganne te kanjiru nama bad afama harra ta usi debi sa sega namni ba ma paje chudan debi se bad afama ta eti kanjiru
heddu sani malifi an jiru yechu hafe yechu daf na tafakata afur da kan bare sani sadan kana ba yanan kan be kamu isan ammat makado fte kana yechu da isan nuti ke sambis ne kunem panemo kube dubu fama yene radurani kana fon nisun mo kube de chada ante fe yechu da debi sirri kan nuf debi se tahir nazif da durse kan debi se yechu da jimara da kan nuf debi se isan ega harrafe abba charrate tinjira pagam medina
enga odefanno garagarati kan isin ranga hatore odefanno kenye kesa enni tokko gamat insa mudan ogessa afirachudan akami akamtin dubisu qabu jollen yokisimo baratton akamtin dubisu qabu kanje dusga